Hello lads, I'm checking in from a verdant forest in the primordial heartlands of Scandinavia. I thought to talk a bit about Viking mentality. I've mentioned some of these things before, but I saw the newest Assassin's Creed trailer where you have a Viking fighting against some Saxons. And I also have seen The Last Kingdom, the two first seasons at least, and I have read Bernard Cornwell's books about Uhtred, and I can definitely recommend them. They are very good books, and the series thus far is also recommended. Now, I will say though, I will start off by talking about the series, The Last Kingdom. It is much better than Vikings. Vikings is a bit silly, if we're being honest with ourselves. But The Last Kingdom, it's good, I can recommend it, but there are a few things I would like to just present to you before I can recommend it. First and foremost, we have to understand Viking mentality or Scandinavian mentality and what kind of perspective you have on things. So, the two things that bothered me with The Last Kingdom. First, there was a torture scene in the first episode, and I have never seen any evidence whatsoever for Vikings or Scandinavians torturing anyone. That's simply not in congruence with Scandinavian nature. If you want to understand Scandinavians, Scandinavian men in particular, you have to look at us from the most pragmatic of perspectives. Torturing someone at a victory feast, it doesn't serve any purpose. Scandinavians are not a particularly cruel people. It's just not in our spirit to behave in that sort of manner. It was only one scene, but I wanted to say it anyway because I thought it was a bit unnecessary to portray Vikings in that way. Now, I'm not saying that Vikings were good boys who did nothing wrong. They definitely killed and pillaged and took people into slavery, etc. But that's at least something you can understand pragmatically why they would do it. Yeah, to make money, etc. Then also, when it comes to Vikings raping, and I will tip my pickelhaube to Survive the Jive, who pointed this out, that there aren't any sources that state that the Vikings ever raped. There is a term called rapine, if I pronounce it correctly, rapine. It's to take someone else's belongings with force. Now, of course, that is something the Vikings did, plunder. But rape, not so much. And this is also something not in line with Swedish sexual morals or Scandinavian sexual morals. Used to be very moral people, the Scandinavians. Not so any longer, but that's a topic for another video. So anyway, first and foremost about the torture scene, has no bearing in history whatsoever. It was an unnecessary scene, but you know, just one scene, so you can look past it. Secondly, also a very Scandinavian thing is that the Vikings were very vain. They took great pride in their appearance. The Vikings in The Last Kingdom are quite grubby, quite dirty, etc. Very historically inaccurate. The Vikings took great care to look at their best. Not a big deal, you know, you can't choose the perfect actors for every role, but you can at least make them a bit more historically accurate and a bit cleaner. So, except for that, I can recommend the series, The Last Kingdom. Now, on to another note. I've talked about it before, I can talk about it again, since we are on the topic. Viking shield maidens. Were there Viking women who partook in combat? Yes. Was it a common sight to see a woman standing in a shield wall? No. The only source I have seen is from good old Vinland, that's America, where a settlement was attacked by the Amerindians, by the Native Americans, who attacked a settlement, and they were met by a ferocious Viking woman who came at them with a sword and managed to drive them off. That's the only source, and it's congruent with the relationship between men and women at the time. Viking women had a high standing in society because they had to take a lot of responsibility. But that did not mean that they were seen as equal warriors. That did not mean that they could decide over their own sexuality. These are liberal misconceptions about Viking women. Basically, what happened was that when the man went out for, you know, a season of raiding, etc., he left the keys to his wife. The wife was then the leader of the household, of the farm, until he got back. So you can see females having a high standing in society, but that does not mean that they could partake in the male raiding party, etc. You know, different thing if a village got attacked or something, or when they settled in England, it was a different kind of social structure. But when you see these mixed war bands, it's very far from reality. Something else that is not a unique thing for Vikings or Scandinavians, it's also that young men go out in the world to prove themselves, then they come back as men and can take a place among the other men, and, you know, can get a wife, etc. So if you want to make a game or a film or a TV series, yeah, sure, you can include female warrior here and there, but it's not a common sight. And also, I'm just gonna throw in a note on physiology. A well-trained woman can, with good technique, you know, knock out a man or choke a man or stab a man with a sword, but no woman can ragdoll several much bigger men at once. And this is something I saw a comment long ago when I posted on Facebook something about Vikings, and it was an English guy who said, you know what, I find it a bit disrespectful that this small Viking shield maiden can ragdoll these big Saxon warriors. And yeah, I agree. It is a bit silly. So that's something to keep in mind also for all filmmakers. Yeah, you can have women utilizing violence, but at least make it realistic. Now, also a note on Viking sexuality and Viking sexual morals. It's an absolute liberal misconception that the Vikings were tolerant of, you know, deviant sexual behavior. They simply weren't. They were driven by honor and shame. You could not bring shame upon yourself. As a woman, you could absolutely not decide over, you know, you couldn't be promiscuous. You might have had a, you know, you had a say in who you got to marry, but that didn't imply that you could sleep around before marriage, basically. And this brings me to my next point. I wanted to talk a bit about the Assassin's Creed trailer. I have the feel, I will see, I can't say too much before the game is released, but the Saxons are being portrayed in the trailer, at least, as the bad guys, and the Vikings as the good guys, even though the Saxons are defending their land. And the Saxons are then being portrayed as, you know, intolerant Christians versus the liberal Viking pagans. I think this will be the angle of the Assassin's Creed game, because you've seen quite a bit of anti-Christian sentiments in previous games. So they're trying to take the Vikings, making them into some hippie pagans who are tolerant and liberal, and then they're fighting off against the intolerant Christians who impose their morals on them. But the Vikings were also intolerant. They took slaves. It's not something I endorse, even. So there is an interesting aspect to that. But anyway, I will talk more about that when I actually play the game, to see if you have those tendencies, that you're using Vikings as a battering ram against, you know, traditional morals. I'm afraid, I'm worried that they will use Vikings as a, you know, they see these big, aesthetic, muscular Viking men as champions of liberal values. I'm a bit worried, actually, but we'll see how it turns out. Now, also a note on trading, etc. The certain liberals always like to point out how tolerant the Vikings were, because they traded with a lot of people. Again, Scandinavians, very practical people. If you can trade with someone, you do it. It doesn't mean that you hold them in high esteem or anything. So if you see they traded goods with the Arabic world, it didn't mean that they were good friends with them. But you know, it's the same thing today. You can have good trading relationships with people outside of your civilization. It doesn't mean anything bad. Now, of course, I don't. I try to keep everything within my civilization, but that's a topic for another video. But I just wanted to mention that, because you might see some liberal using that as an argument to reinforce the notion that the Vikings were the original good boy liberals, but absolutely not the case. And I'm not a Christian myself, so I'm not necessarily defending Christianity, but the argument that the Vikings became more intolerant when they became Christian doesn't really hold up. Tolerance is something you can afford when you have a lot of money, like Sweden has had for the last 50 years. Then you can be tolerant of a lot of deviant behavior, but when times get tough, tolerance goes out the window. So it's more a matter of material wealth in regards to tolerance, not necessarily your religion. So anyway, that was just an additional point. So thank you for watching. XOXO, boom.